Hello there, I'm Jorge Lima. I'm presenting this work on behalf of José Oliveira, who is doing his master at Federal University of Bahia. This work is on implementing and evaluating real-time scheduling algorithms in embedded pre-RTOS based systems. Pre-RTOS is an operating system targeting small systems. I'll introduce some basic concepts on real-time scheduling, and then we move to the motivation of our work. Real-time scheduling is a basic and fundamental problem in real-time systems design, and solutions for this problem intend to distribute the computing resource to the system tasks so that all the tasks meet the deadlines. And classical approaches are based on assigning priority to tasks so that at runtime, this operating system can select the highest priority at a given time to run. And if we're doing priority-based scheduling, there are two ways of doing so. One is assigning priority at design time, which is called fixed priority scheduling. And on the other hand, we can do also the assignment of priorities during runtime. In this case, we are talking about dynamic priority scheduling. Fixed priority scheduling incurs lower overhead, but allows for a lower utilization for the system due to schedulability issues. Dynamic scheduling, on the other hand, requires higher overhead because we have to deal with dynamic priority queues, reorganizing the task queues. So it requires more resources for the system just for the scheduling when compared to fixed priority. But also it allows for higher utilization of the system. So we ask the question whether dynamic priority scheduling pays off if we are doing implementing actually using in an actual system. And real-time OS targeting small embedded system usually implements only fixed priority scheduling due to its simplicity and low overhead. This is an example of the real-time atomic scheduling for a very simple task system. Two tasks, two periodic tasks. Task two has a period of two, and task one has a period of two. Task two has a period of three, which means that they are released periodically at 2 and 3 time units recurrently in the system. In this example, they both require one time unit to execute, and they must meet the deadlines, which are in this case equal to the period. As you can see, the schedule is done so that the system chooses to execute task one whenever task one is ready, delaying the task two, which in this case is the lowest priority task. The dynamic priority scheduling, in this case, we are talking about EDF, which is our algorithm that we are experimenting with. The assignment of priority is based on the deadline of the job of the task, which means that the deadline can change, or actually the priority can change because the deadline changes during runtime. And the highest priority task is the one that has the earliest deadline. So the example works exactly the same way as in the previous slide. As you can see, the generated schedule is the same in this example, but I will show now some difference between them. And this goes to the motivation of this work. Repeating the example for another, repeating the application of rate monotonic NDF for another example, with two tasks, but now task two requires 1.5 time units, each 3 time units. So the system now has to offer 100% of utilization, 100% of the processor for the system task. As you can see, written authentic scheduling cannot deal with this kind of system. The first instance of task 2 misses the deadlines because there is just one slack time available to execute task 2 during the period of between 0 and 3 time minutes. And there is no extra slack during this window. And since priorities are fixed, whenever task 2 appears, is released, it preempts task 2. And EDF, on the other hand, can manage this example quite easily. As you can see here, the first instance of task 2 has higher priority than the second instance of the task 1, delaying the start of execution. And as you can see, there is no missed deadline and the processor is fully utilized. Well, this work intends to answer the following question: targeting small embedded system. Does the higher process utilization that EDF has also for compensate for the dynamic priority assignment overhead? And if so, to what extent? And we are considering two implementations of EDF for answering this question. And again, we are targeting a microcontroller, in this case, ARM Cortex M4, which has a low computing capacity board. One of the implementations that we are considering is the classic one. Priority queues are managed via a mean heap data structure, which is basically a binary tree with some properties. And the highest priority task goes at the root of the tree. But when we dequeue or enqueue tasks using this data structure, we need to take care of reorganizing the tree, which takes log n for n tasks steps. The second implementation that we're considering is the one that is pattern described in this paper that appeared in Dates 2016. And the priority queue is structured as a set of lists, and there are n lists for n tasks in the system. There is also a bitmap vector, which identifies which set of lists should be searched for when you're looking for tasks. And details of this implementation can be seen in the paper, in the date paper, or in the out paper in this conference. And we are going to skip that for the sake of time. Well, now we move to our evaluating these implementations via experiments. Those experiments are conducted using the microcontroller, Cortex-M4. Task sets were randomly generated using UUFS, which ensures non-biased way of generating system tasks. We are considering system with up to 60 tasks, and there are two types of task sets that we are giving. We call them easy task sets or hard task sets. The easy one are those that for which the period of the task varies in a larger window of time. And the opposite of the hard type, for which the task has a short period of time, which means that they are releasing tasks in a shorter time window, so incurring more overhead, more preemptions or context suites and so on. And we use three metrics in this evaluation, context switch overhead, scheduling overhead, and scalability. So basically, we are checking the amount of overhead due to context switch, due to managing priority queues or executing functions related to scheduling, to deciding which task should run at runtime. In scalability, we are accessing the amount of generated task sets that are considered scalable, correctly scalable in the system. For the first metric, context switch, as you can see here, both graphs shows that there is no big deal in terms of difference between the three evaluated algorithms. The rate monotone scheduling is the native uses the native fixed priority scheduling provided by FreeRTOS, and EDF L and the EDF H are those versions of EDF described earlier, based on the lists and based on heap. As you can see, there is no difference, so context switch is not what differentiates them. In terms of scheduling overhead, we can see that they perform quite differently, mainly for hard type of task sets. As you can see, EDFL, the version that uses the list to implement the task queue, are in between, performs in between the rate monotone scheduling and the EDF based on heap. Of course, the lowest overhead is the rate monotone scheduling, as expected, because the priority queue is much simpler. In terms of scalability, on the other hand, we can see that we have a degradation of accepting systems. There are systems that are not considered scalable. Tasks miss the deadline if they're executing according to EDF L and EDF H, but EDF L performs much better than EDF H, based on which is based on the heap. Rate monotone scheduling, as you can see, is the one that performs quite poorly when we are seeing the easy tasks. For the hard tasks, this is more evident. The performance degrades a lot. We're seeing here that we are able to schedule only half of the task sets that are generated if we use the rate monotone scheduling. So when we are seeing the task sets as large as 20, only 50% of the task sets generated were considered scalable. And this number drops considerably until when you see task sets as large as containing 40 tasks, there is no task set that are generated without missing deadlines. And so, but the performance of the EDF L, on the other hand, is quite good when we compare to EDF H in both cases. And for the easy task sets, we see that it performs like in predicted in theory, 100% of the task sets were able to be scaled successfully in the system for all task sets sizes. And also to complete the experiments, we generated two extreme scenarios, one containing 10 tasks only for the easy tasks, the task type, and the other one with 60 tasks with the hard type. As you can see here, again, EDF H performs worse than EDF L. And for both tasks, actually rate monotonic scheduling performs worse than both versions of EDF for the easy one, and for the hard one, it's performs a little bit better than EDF based on heap. I forgot to say these graphs in the X axis, we see the percentage of CPU required by the task sets that are being generated. So, well, this then we come to the following conclusion: EDF can be an alternative. An alternative for implementation for small embedded systems, if this is the approach that implements the queue is efficient. And based on this observation, we are now trying to using this for energy savings in a small embedded system using EDF. Implemented based on the least implementation. That's all. Thank you very much for your attention. I would be happy to answer possible questions.